In this video, we'll provide a brief introduction to using Shiftboard as a new member. Shiftboard is a real-time online scheduling system. You can view your calendar, request shifts, and send messages using the tools in Shiftboard. Viewing or joining workgroups, called teams in this video, can be done from the Teams menu. You can click on the Calendar button to go straight to the calendar, or use the menu to navigate to Availability to quickly find sign-up shifts, shifts that are available on the trade board, or to view time off requests. The Opportunity menu shows you other information that you may find useful, like the news page, job board, and shift trade opportunities. We are currently looking at the news page, which is like a bulletin board or announcement section for your organization. When you arrive at the news page, you'll see a pop-up box with some helpful tips and links. The first time you log in, you will probably want to change your password to something that you can remember. Some of Shiftboard's timekeeping tools also require a numerical PIN, and you can set that here as well. Your new password must be at least 8 characters long and should contain both numbers and letters. You can also change your password and PIN within your account details, which you can access by clicking on your name. In your account, you can update your basic contact information or upload a picture. Information in your account is organized into different sections. You may want to view or alter information in your profile area, view your team or work group memberships, view or update your availability, update your resume or other documents, or alter your notification preferences. You also see broadcast and direct messages by email. Messages are also sent to your Shiftboard message box. New messages are indicated by a number next to your name.
Here you can view, send, and respond to messages from your manager or sent to your team or to the organization. Finally, we'll take a look at the calendar. This is the time stacked week view, where shifts are displayed for a week from earliest start time to latest start time. Filled shifts appear in green and will have your name in them to indicate that you are working that shift, while open shifts appear in red. You can click on a shift in any view to see more details about it. Any shift that has a location associated with it will display a link to a Google map so that you can easily get directions. To get more work, click on an available shift. Then click the Take This Shift button. Some shifts won't have this button and will instead have a sign-up list that you can use to let your manager know that you are interested in a shift. This weekly time view is just one of the many views on the calendar. You can also view the weekly calendar with a staff focus, view a single day, view your shifts by hour throughout the day, or view a list of shifts so that you can quickly offer to work a selection at one time. As you can see, the more we zoom in, the more information appears next to each shift. However, even if we zoom all the way out to the month view, you can always click on a shift to bring up the details pane on the right-hand side of the screen. There are many additional ways to view the calendar. We are currently using the shift view to view your own shifts, but you can instead use the shared view to see who you're working with. Or you can use the sign-up view to see which shifts have sign-up lists. Even with sign-up lists, red shifts are available, green shifts are the ones you've been chosen for, and now gray shifts are those that you've signed up for, but for which you haven't yet been chosen. Many people prefer the weekly time view, but you can choose the best option for your needs.
You can indicate filters that you'd like to enable and save them for next time if you'd like. You can remove individual filters just by unchecking them and searching again. If you'd like to keep these filters active, but don't want them to take up space at the top of your screen, you can hide them and bring them back at any time. Even if you don't save these filters for next time, they'll stick around until you log out or change them.
Anytime you don't see what you expect on the calendar, make sure that you're looking at the correct view and that you don't have any filters enabled. This has been just a brief overview of using Shiftboard, but you can get much more information by clicking on the Help button for more documentation and additional videos, or click on the Feedback button to get in touch with your site administrator.